Joe?
Well, I just wanted to say that I really appreciated your proposal that you made to the council. It was exciting. Kimberly and I were on the committee that made a recommendation to the full council, and we were just very excited about what you were offering. And so I look forward to welcoming you, first of all, to Salinas, and looking really forward to seeing what you're gonna present to us. So thank you.
Okay, Steve.
Like Councilmember Lutz, I share great enthusiasm and excitement looking over both proposals. I was one of the guys that voted on the local firm. We've made a decision moving forward, and I know that there's detail in there and your effort to embrace locals in building your program. So I offer myself, as I'm sure every other council member would, and really look forward to what you come up with. So thanks for being here, too.
Kimberly, then Gloria.
Mark, thanks for taking us on. Appreciate it. Having reviewed the proposal at hand, very standard, going through line by line, very standard contract that we have, and I'm really excited about the stakeholder interviews. Part of I'm going to get the name wrong. What's the name of the company that you did the interviews with? The Solutia. Thank you. They train community leaders, and then those leaders go out and train their communities, whether it be the faith-based community or, in this particular case, it was in the business sector. But I'm really excited about, and one of the things I ran on was rebranding the city, perception as reality, and we really need to start speaking and acting more positively about our city. And secondarily, as we aggressively move forward in economic development, and we are going after developers and putting together an ED package to incentivize people to come, we need to have a brand. And I'm really excited. I went through, I spoke with you, I called you when the vote came down, I did interviews. I'm really excited that you are taking us on, so thank you.
Okay. Gloria?
Yes, I also want to thank you also. I was one of them that voted for the expertise, because I saw that you had a lot of experience. So again, I'm very thrilled and excited about you being here and what you're going to do for us.
Good. Okay, Sergio?
I was one of those guys that supported the local guy, but I do stand behind the council's position and supporting you, and I do support you. I do want to again encourage you personally to include our local folks. TMD is a great firm. That's a lot of great work, and they competed, and obviously you got the gig. So just work with them, work with our local merchants, work if you're going to produce any materials. We have a printer that does organic, uses organic ink, recycled papers, all those. So use local folks as much as you can. We do appreciate you taking the risk with us, because there's no guarantees and you put in it all in it. So definitely appreciate that. Did support the local guy, but now you're local too. So we support you.
Well, I think, and we'll be looking for a motion to enter into the agreement. I think, you know, what folks fail to note, and you've heard some of the, local, and, you being from St. Louis, you're probably familiar with Taste Great, Less Filling. But where the council was completely united is, let's do this. That there was complete agreement on, and I think sometimes people get caught up in, who was for who. I mean, in the end, a choice had to be made, but there was unanimity around great idea, and the fact that we were all very pleased that a couple of firms that were willing to buy into this approach on behalf of the community. So, and what I like about it is, a lot of people ask me, has something like this ever been done before, really? And so I think this is kind of cutting edge stuff. And, and for what it's worth, and I say this a little tongue in cheek, in terms of your anticipated profit, I'm so confident in the future of Salinas, I actually think you sandbagged us and it's low, and you're going to make a lot more. So I think you've got a heck of an opportunity, because I think we're going to give you a heck of a city to market. So,
Mr. Mayor,
yes.
Move to enter into the agreement with Avant Marketing Group.
Second.
Okay, Ann.
Councilmember Barrera?
Aye.
Councilmember Craig?
Aye.
Councilmember De La Rosa?
Aye.
Councilmember Lutz?
Aye.
Councilmember McShane?
Aye.
Councilmember Sanchez?
Yes.
Mayor Donahue?
Yes. You can go to bed now. Anyway, now I'm not going to put you on the spot. You are staying in Salinas, right?
Yes, absolutely.
Very good.
We're in Salinas, too.
Okay, as you should. All right. Very good. Watch out. There's a guy who owns a restaurant right across the street. He lurks, so he's going to try and get you over there before you go. All right. Very good. Okay. Try the jerk chicken. No, it's good. Let's see. Jeff, you've still got the floor, and we're going to talk about impact fee deferrals.
Mr. Mayor, members of the council, I was asked a while back to bring something to you as quickly as I can, and that's, you see before you information from six different cities on how they have addressed deferral of impact fees. Not the elimination, but deferral. And the program opportunities they offer are all unique. And one of the things I wanted to share with you is they're all unique to every different city. You'll notice there are approaches where some you pay at the time of certificate of occupancy, some you pay over 5 years, some you pay in different ways over periods of time. So what I wanted the council to know, first of all, is we're responding to what you asked to do as quickly as possible. Secondly, there are a number of choices, and I would ask for guidance on how you'd like us to either bring to you a matrix or sit down with a subcommittee or anything to go forward next, but to do this quickly. I think it is important. Now, you have the feeling, just as we did on Saturday, we are in a hurry. We're trying to get there, but we need to do it in a measured way. There are choices. Do you want to go for certain businesses, certain areas of the city? You know, there was those kind of things. And I'm just, I stand here ready to respond to whatever you'd like me to do next.
Okay, so we'll go ahead and proceed with our council questions, yes. Public comment, then back to council for direction. If I hear you correctly, really the nature of your staff report is there's a lot of different ways to do this, so you would rather have the council through question and then feedback provide.
That would be just fine with me, and then we can bring something as quickly as we can.
Okay, well, let's see if there's any questions from council at this point.
Well, wouldn't it be appropriate, Jeff, to refer this to the Economic Development Subcommittee when that, I mean, it sounds like that.
That was, Councilmember McShane, that was my original intent. We're not sure when that'll be put together. Okay. And I have the feeling we would like to do this earlier rather than later. It's up to.
It's development.
Yeah.
Is it the business development?
Well, if you've spoke about a sense of urgency, I think the place to get immediate feedback is the business development group, which brings together Building Exchange, Chamber, SUBA, Old Town.
Most certainly. And I'm just trying to think when the next meeting is. I believe, excuse me, Tom, I think, is it on Thursday? I can get this in front of them on Thursday. As early as that, if that's what you'd like me to do, and then we can meet with them.
Okay. Well, we'll proceed through the process. Let me just stay with Steve, then go to Jill.
Okay. So along those lines, I do think it's important that council be engaged, and so there's these talks, or I've heard from I think the city manager at one point that there would be an economic committee of the or economic development committee of this council. Maybe that's going to happen, maybe it's not. Either way, I don't know if there's a council representative that sits on the business development task force. As far as I know, they're open meetings, anybody can come, the coffee's always warm, you know, that kind of thing. So I don't know what sort of teeth are there. So to send it to the business development task force, regardless, I mean, who knows, hopefully there's time on their agenda, that'll give, you know, some good vetting. But I think it would be appropriate that there be a little bit of a deeper dive. So at some point, it sounds like that's going to be appropriate. I don't know. Sorry. Okay.
Okay. No, that's fine. Jill?
I'm just curious because I think that this is really critical, Jeff, and I'm so glad you brought it to the council. But of the ones that you've recommended for the development impact fee deferrals, which one would you recommend? Ontario, Turlock, Oakley, Woodland, Elk Grove, or Stockton?
I personally like the one that, like, I think it's called the 10-20-30 program.
Mm-hmm.
I think that actually allows greatest flexibility. But how would you like it implemented, and what would you like it focused on? So I think we could talk about a program, but an area of emphasis. Do you want to do it project opportunities of a certain value, project opportunities that create at least a certain amount of fees. Some communities, it's $20,000 is a minimum. So, and those are the kind of questions that, you know, I, I'd rather share, have dialogue with someone on
right.
than just say, here's what I think you should do.
Although I certainly appreciate your bringing this to us and really promoting the need for flexibility, because that's what's going to be key in this environment. So personally, I think that if we, I mean, yes, business community, fine, but I would sure feel comfortable if Jeff just brought us something, you know, as quickly as possible.
Okay. Okay. Anyone else? Okay. Public?
Mr. Mayor and City Council, my name is Tom Carvey, the President and CEO of the Salinas Valley Chamber of Commerce, and I think it's a tremendous idea to have some kind of deferment of impact fees. Could help our city move forward with development, which we so badly need. And as you've already mentioned, Jeff has already mentioned, you're not alone in this. And if I may read a couple of releases, you're probably on the same mailing list, I think. But one of these is from the City of Stockton, and the newspaper report says, in a bid to breathe life into Stockton's sickened economy and lure companies interested in expanding, City Hall will temporarily slash and delay collection of many fees. And then you go to Chula Vista, and you've probably read this one too, but trying to be more welcome to developers, the Chula Vista City Council has streamlined the sometimes frustrating process that builders have to go through before construction can begin. The City of Highland, a temporary fee reduction program enacted last year, the City of Paradise, the City of San Bernardino, the Irvine City Council, the Tulare City Council, Rancho Sacramento, Petaluma, North County, Glendale, San Luis Obispo, Stockton, Riverside, and the list goes on and on and on. These are cities that are similar to Salinas, and what they're doing is they're realizing that developers aren't going to come if their fees are too high. So they're incrementally and decisively determining to defer or to lower some of those fees so as to lure that capital investment into their city. And if you think of where our construction industry is today, it has never been worse. And I can tell you from the Chamber of Commerce perspective, there are many of our members who are not just hurting in business, they're out of business. There is no business. And you think of our housing problem that we have a severe housing shortage. We know that in Census District 7, that the housing densities in Census District 7 are higher than on Manhattan Island. So we have a housing deficiency, we have no construction going on, we have no development, and it would be wise to defer fees. And of course, in the last little phrase, we don't want to eliminate fees. We don't want to create second-class neighborhoods where there's no proper infrastructure, but you get the gist. Thank you.
Got it. Thanks, Tom. All right. Anyone else? All right. Back to council. All right.
Mayor.
Jill.
I want to get Jeff's feeling on this, but I really think that if there is an urgency, and I think there is, that we should ask Jeff to come up with a suggestion for us. I think to wait to the creation of a business community or business council is time consuming. And I think that Jeff certainly has the back of all the businesses, and certainly from what we just heard Tom say, he seems in very much agreement with this. I think we should just ask Jeff to come back with his recommendation.
Let's call him and find out. All right, anyone else? All right,
Sorry, yonder in the distance. I actually like the idea of working with the Business Development Task Force. I think that would be a great way to get to weigh in with some of the business community. I'm certainly willing to sit in on that meeting as well to give my perspective if that's helpful. But I do think, Jeff, you know, I know you say I don't want to be out there in left field all by myself making the decision, but having that opportunity to talk to the business community, I think, would be beneficial.
I think I will echo both Councilmember Lutz and Craig, that there should be a sense of urgency, a very quick, timely way to do this. And frankly, as is custom and habit, we run it through the business development group, which routinely provides feedback, and then we should be able to loop back around for the next council session.
And that already exists, right?
That group exists. I mean, that's really kind of typically been the routine vehicle to, if we want some business feedback, you run it through there, because you have Builders Exchange, you have Chamber, you have SUBA, you have Old Town.
And do we have a council member that